Welcome to the Veteran Affairs Showcase. I'm Liz Graybill, Berks County Department of Veteran Affairs Community Relations Programs Manager for the department. On this showcase, we highlight veteran benefits and services, but today we are going to talk about the veteran events that has taken place in November and a few events that are upcoming. Callers, the number to call in on is 610-378-0426. If you served in the military, you are a veteran. On behalf of the Berks County Department of Veteran Affairs, we understand all the sacrifices you have made while serving in the military, and we want to say thank you for your service to our country. There were a lot of veteran events in November, and I would like to give an extra special thank you to the Reading Eagle and other local newspapers, WEEU, and television stations for all the excellent coverage to the veteran events during the month. It is important that we continue to support veteran events to help spread the word about the event and to capture veteran stories. So thank you very much for the coverage. Local churches honored veterans during their church services. Just by honoring veterans and opening their doors to veterans brought some veterans out to attend churches for the very first time, and that is amazing in itself. A lot of businesses honored the veteran services to our country by way of offering a military discount or free meal or veterans, and our veterans really appreciate any time that we are honored. Thank you to our businesses for honoring veterans. Some businesses offer a veteran discount every day, and some only do it on Veterans Day, and that's okay. It is up to the business if and when they offer a discount to a veteran. I can tell you, whenever a business offers a discount to a veteran, it is always greatly appreciated. Thank you. Please show the email address. To those listening businesses, if you would like to let me know the discounts you offer to veterans, when, and the amount of the discount, and what document or ID card you require for that discount, that would be greatly appreciated. Please email that information to me at egraybill@countyofberks.com. And then, with that information you email me, I will put together a list for veterans who want to know where they can save money when they shop or eat out. And that will help veterans to patronize your business if you give a discount. So please let me know. Email that information to me. I want to let you know that if you have your original discharge papers, the DD Form 214, your military discharge, you can take that to the Recorder of Deeds office on the third floor of the County Service Center to have it recorded. Having it recorded means they are just going to make a copy of it and they give the original back to you. Once you go to the Recorder of Deeds office, they make a copy, you go down the hallway to the Sheriff's office, they will take your photo. Instantly you will receive the Berks County Veterans ID card. This Veterans ID card may possibly be accepted at businesses to give you a veteran's discount. Remember, it is up to the business whether they accept this card or whether they give you a discount or not. Please record your discharge whether you receive a discount or not. It's very important you record your discharge to safeguard this very important document. Schools and personal living homes invited in veterans to speak so the veteran could tell their story. That is a great way for veterans to get involved with the communities and a great way for the students to learn about the veteran story and to ask questions to veterans. Thank you all for those opportunities for our veterans to come out and share their stories. Please put the veteran there. The photo on the screen is Reading Royals. They had a military appreciation night. There's three veterans in that photo. The center one is a general from Indiantown Gap. He came out to the military appreciation night just to thank veterans for their service. Like I said, the Reading Royals had a night to honor veterans. They gave free tickets to veterans to encourage them to come on out. Then they played the service medley song and asked you to stand on your song. So that was a good evening. The Marine birthday cake. The U.S. Marine Corps' birthday is always November 10th. At the Berks County Veteran Appreciation Dinner Dance, the Marines had a small cake cutting ceremony to celebrate the Marine Corps birthday. The Marines were taken into a separate room for this ceremony, and all the Marines were together. On the screen here is a Marine Corps League commandant, like the commander of the organization. I have a couple other pictures of the Marines. Here are two Marines dressed in their dress blues, Frank Salamone and Robert Orgachowski. They were also in the cake cutting ceremony room. And then there's another picture of a Marine with a four-star general. He was a guest speaker at the Veteran Appreciation Dinner Dance, General Magnus. He's retired general for the Marine Corps. Okay, now we're moving along to the Veteran Appreciation Dinner Dance. That was an event that was held at the Wilson High School. The Veteran Appreciation Dinner Dance is a great opportunity for veteran and veteran supporters to come out and enjoy the evening with camaraderie. Will you show the Veteran Appreciation Dinner Dance? On this photo, the evening at the dance begins with a dinner and then a formal part, which included the POW MIA table, inducting two new members into the Berks County Military Hall of Fame. And the two photos we just showed you were General Carl Spotts, U.S. Army Air Force, World War II. He was recognized for the Distinguished Service Cross, and his granddaughter stood in to receive the award for the family. That was the first Military Hall of Fame photo I showed you, was this year. The one on the screen is a previous year's Military Hall of Fame inductee into the Berks County Military Hall of Fame. So that's Walt Gismeyer. And then also recognized this year was Sergeant Wayne Miller, U.S. Army, Air Force, World War II, for the Silver Star, and his daughter stood in to receive the award for the family. On the screen now, there is a picture of the Wilson JROTC students. They were doing a march drill for the audience to see. That's during the formal part. Also, we presented an Eagle Award to Steve Moyer for outstanding veteran for all his volunteer work he does with veterans. And then the dance is followed by an informal part where there's dancing and socializing. And I just took a few photos from the dance and put up on the screen. It is breathtaking when you walk into the auditorium and see everything decorated for the evening's events. The dance is decorated very patriotic with American flags hung throughout the auditorium. There were centerpieces on each table with a red, white, and blue theme on each table. There were two military jeeps on display inside the auditorium that gave the evening that military feel. Music of each era was played for those in attendance to dance to the music they grew up hearing, like a USO show. The best way to describe the evening is it is just like a veterans prom for veterans and veteran supporters to come out and celebrate veterans and have a great time. On Veterans Day, there were so many events that a veteran could attend, and they possibly could not attend all of the events. Even if they wanted to, the veteran was just too busy on Veterans Day. Thank you to everyone and every organization that held an event for veterans on Veterans Day. Thank you all for making veterans feel special on their day. Continue to thank veterans for their military service and sacrifices they made to defend our great nation. Veterans, we must learn to accept the compliment when someone says thank you for your service. I have a photo of a veteran speaking Okay. This is a veteran who was speaking at Manor at Market Square the morning of Veterans Day. And then he rushed off to speak other places. On Veterans Day, many veterans were able to speak at events. What an honor to allow a veteran the opportunity to speak on any day, especially on Veterans Day. Please show the Veterans Day ceremony pictures. There was a ceremony at Veterans Grove City Park that was well attended by many veterans and veteran organizations. Several people spoke, stating how important veterans are to them. Several veterans were able to speak and talk about their sacrifices. Many wreaths were placed in honor of veterans. The photo on the screen is the color guard, the Revolutionary War color guard. They're very nice reenactors dressed. It's very nice at the ceremony to have a color guard present. After this ceremony, several VFWs and American Legions held free lunches to veterans. Restaurants offered free meals or discounted meals or free appetizers to veterans. The Wyomissing High School had a career day and invited in several different people with many different occupations, including Army reservists, veterans, and recruiters to talk about their military experiences. There was a flag retirement ceremony held at the Daniel Boone Homestead. A flag retirement ceremony is a ceremony to properly retire worn out and old faded American flags by very respectfully burning. As each flag is retired, you face the audience and say, "I retire this flag in honor of my father, who served in," and you state the war and state the branch of service and the period they served. Then you place the flag in the fire. At this specific flag retirement ceremony, Stuart Lurch, who was only 7 months old when his father was killed in action while he was in the Army during World War II, had the opportunity of placing a flag in the fire in honor of his father, and that was the first time he attended a flag retirement ceremony and had the honor to retire a flag in his father's honor. Stuart never knew his father, so this flag retirement ceremony gave him a sense of closure. There was also a wreath-laying ceremony at the Reading Stadium at the Dog Takes. That was well attended also. There were several veteran events in the month of November, and I cannot possibly begin to talk about them all or show photos for all of them or highlight every veteran. I just wanted to thank the establishments and the organizations that put everything together and made everything a very successful day for the veterans on Veterans Day. To the listening audience, I would like to say thank you for honoring veterans. Continue to say thank you to veterans who are serving or have served their country. For everyone and every organization that held an event for veterans during the month, thank you. Veterans, again, thank you for your military service. I salute you. An upcoming event I would like to tell you about on Saturday, this Saturday, November 23rd, is a welcome home event for veterans at the West Lawn United Methodist Church beginning at 10 a.m. This event is for all veterans, regardless of when they served. There will be a guest speaker. Organizations will be present with information at their tables about what their organization offers, and several breakout sessions that the veterans can choose to attend which of the sessions they want to get further information. I would like to inform you again about the Berks County Veterans ID card, which you can obtain if you have your original military discharge, the DD Form 214 or its equivalent. You would take that to the Recorder of Deeds in the County Service Center. Then you would obtain your Berks County Veterans ID card, and that will be printed immediately. that ID card can possibly be used at businesses and restaurants for a veteran's discount. It is up to the business whether they accept the card or offer a veteran discount or not. They do not have to offer a veteran discount, and if they do not, you do not have to inform the Veteran Affairs Office. It's up to the business if they want to give you a discount or not. Every Tuesday in our office at 1:30, we offer a veterans benefit presentation. This is for veteran and spouses to attend so you know what benefits you may be entitled to. You do not need to let us know you are attending. Just show up to our office located at 726 Cherry Street, and parking is free under the BARTA bus terminal. The briefing lasts about an hour and a half to 2 hours. It's very informative. I highly recommend you to come out and learn about your benefits that you may be entitled to. After that briefing, if you realize you are entitled to benefits, we highly encourage you to schedule an appointment with our office so we are available when you walk in, and then we'll have time set aside just to wait on you and help you with your benefits. Okay, I encourage you to come out, like I said, to the Tuesday briefing, 1:30, for the Veterans Benefit presentation. Our office does have a museum, and after your appointment, please check out our museum. Am I over? Okay, I just want to let you know our office will be closed for Thanksgiving, Thursday, November 28th. And Friday, November 29th, for the day after Thanksgiving. Thank you for joining us on the Berks television show, Veteran Affairs Showcase. Thank you. Goodbye.